Assalamu alaikum, dear students. It's our first class after the discontinuation of our studies due to the pandemic COVID-19. Let's continue our studies online through Nutrition Camp 446. In continuation of our previous lectures, today we will learn about the next lecture, and that is the basal metabolism. The layout include what is calorie. Calories in food, the resting energy expenditure or basal metabolism, the basal metabolic rate determination, and the different factors which affect the basal metabolic rate. Before starting the lectures, let's have a look over that what a calorie is. So consider the example of an automobile. Just like automobiles burn fuel or gasoline to get the energy to move, and that energy is needed to move. So similarly, our body burns different metabolites like the fats, carbohydrates, and lipids in the form which are present in the food to produce energy in the form of the heat. And this heat warms our body, and as energy powers every move our body make. So we can say that the food is metabolized in the body, energy is released to perform all our body activities. The calorie is the basic unit of heat measurement, and that is the amount of heat produced by metabolizing food in units called kilocalories. While the kilocalorie is the amount of energy it takes to raise the temperature of 1 kilogram of water 1 degree on a centigrade Celsius thermometer at sea level. It in common use, normally the nutritionalist substitute the word calorie from the kilocalorie. So now how we count the calories in food, we'll learn about that. There is a about the serving of the food, like the 1 serving, 2 serving, 3 serving, and it is like that. If you consider the example of a banana, and that 1 banana has 105 calories, so it means that by metabolizing that 1 banana, it produced 105 calories of heat in the body that our body can use for work. So we can say that 1 gram of protein gives 4 calories, and 1 gram of carbohydrates will only produce 4 calories, while 1 gram of the fat gives you the 9 calories of energies. So now here the question arises that how many calories do we need actually? And that is depend upon the amount of the energy which is consumed by our body each day, and is divided into 2 parts. That first is that energy which is consumed by our body at rest while we are doing nothing, or we can say that all involuntary actions which are taking place inside our body, like the respiration, the heartbeat, the circulation, or the digestion, etc. And second is that energy which is consumed by our body to perform all the physical activity, like the walking, the running, the eating, talking, watching a TV, or doing exercise, etc. So growth period also need extra energy per pound than adult because of continuous new cell synthesis. While the energy requirement of men or women is also greater, that will be explained later. So the color, we can totally calculate the calorific requirement of a person, and there are basically 4 needs upon which we can calculate, we can determine the overall calorific requirement of a person. And these are: the first one is the basal metabolism, second is the metabolic activity, third is the growth and illness, and fourth is the diet induced thermogenesis. So first of all, we will study about the basal metabolism, and it is basically is that amount of energy which is expended while at rest in a neutrally temperate environment in the post-absorptive state, meaning that the digestive system is completely inactive, which requires about 12 hours of fasting. So it is the sum of the all internal chemical activities or the proper functioning of other vital organs, such as the heart, the lungs expand and contract, the blood circulation, the production of hormones, the intestine digesting food, the liver process different nutrients, our muscles flex usually gently, and the cells send electrical impulses back and forth among themselves, and of course, or monitor the brain, which continuously signals to every part of our body. So it is the sum of our internal chemical activities that maintain the body at rest. So the energy that our resting body uses to do other involuntary actions is actually called the resting energy expenditure or the basal metabolism. The basal metabolic rate is, so we can conclude it as that it is the minimum calorific requirement which is needed to sustain life in a resting individual, or the amount of energy expended by the body to maintain a bad sleep all the day. And the basal metabolic rate can be responsible for or can use around about the 70% of all the calories which we take in a whole day. So we can calculate the or measure the basal metabolic rate by two methods. First is the direct calorimetry, and second one is the indirect calorimetry. So first we will study about the direct calorimetry. In this method, required subject human to be sit inside the respiration chambers to measure the amount of heat evolved. Water is added in the respiration chamber to find out the basal metabolic rate. Well, this equipment consists of an airtight copper chamber insulated by wooden walls with an air space in between, while a folding bed, chair or a table is provided in the respiration chamber for the subject that can comfortably stay there for a few days, while a small opening is provided at the two ends of the chamber for providing food, drinks and removing excretions. So the chamber is ventilated by a current of air, and the carbon dioxide and water given off are removed by the soda lime and sulfuric acid respectively. So current of so for the next, for the known amount of air is passed to the chamber for oxygen supply and is introduced through a gas meter with an air current. So the consumption of oxygen and production of carbon dioxide are calculated using a formula. So the heat produced is also measured by circulating current amount of water through copper pipes and measuring the quantity of water that has been circulated through the chamber. And also the difference between the temperature of water entering and leaving the chamber. So this method measures the exchange of gases in respiration, and that is by the respiratory quotient while the subject is at rest. So we can say that the respiratory quotient can be measured, which is the ratio of carbon dioxide produced to carbon dioxide consumed. So we can say that the RQ or the respiratory quotient is equal to volume of the carbon dioxide produced divided by the volume of oxygen consumed. And from this respiratory quotient, we can easily determine whether carbohydrate, fat or protein was used for energy by the subject. Another method for the calculating the basal metabolic rate is the indirect calorimetric method, and is used based on the fact that the oxygen used and carbon dioxide produced is in proportion to the heat generated. So the BMR can be made by indirect calorimetric methods depend upon the certain conditions, like the post absorptive state, and that is around normally 12 to 16 hours minimum, and that is after the meal, and the preferable time is the morning, and the subject should be awake and should be at rest and relaxed and free from emotional stress or fear of the test itself. While the normal body temperature should be also maintained, while and the room temperature should also be maintained. And for this measurement, we use the Benedict hand froth apparatus. And this apparatus is basically a closed circuit system in which the subject breathes in oxygen from a metal cylinder of about 6 liter capacity of and carbon dioxide, which is absorbed, produced is absorbed by the soda lime present in the tower. The oxygen cylinder float on the water present in the outer tank. While the subject should wear a nose clip and breathe through a mouthpiece, and the oxygen present in the cylinder for a period of 6 minutes. While the volume of oxygen which is used is recorded in a graph attached. While since the subject is in a post-absorptive state, and so the R respiratory quotient is assumed to be 0.82, and the calorific value of 1 liter of oxygen consumed is taken as 4.8 kilocalories. So if you take the example that if the subject is an adult man of having 50 kilogram of body weight, so the oxygen consumed in 6 minutes is equal to 1100 ml, while the heat produced in 6 minutes is equal to 1100 into 4.8 is equal to 5.28 kilocalorie. Heat produced in 24 hours is equal to 5.2 into 10 into 24 is equal to 1248. So the basal metabolism of an individual for 24 hours is 1248 kilocalories. So this is basically actually that amount of the energy which is required to for maintaining the vital by the vital organs to perform all the involuntary actions which are taking place inside the body. So BMR can also be determined by the calculation method beside the direct and indirect calorimetry, and the table is given, and by putting the values we can easily determine a specific basal metabolic rate of any subject. So how now there are different factors which affect the basal metabolic rate, and among them the most important is the body surface area. So the study showed that the basal metabolic rate is more closely related to the body surface area and less directly related to the weight and height of the individual. So the body size matters a lot. Greater the surface area, the body higher will be the basal metabolic rate. Tall, thin people have higher BMR as the heat loss in body is proportional to the skin surface. A tall and thin person have greater surface and thus higher basal metabolic rate as compared to the short person. Another factor is obviously the genetics. And the genetics, some people's have a great genetically faster metabolism, while some have slower one. And gender also contribute in determining the basal metabolic rate. Like the female have higher metabolic rate. Female have 5% lower basal metabolic rate than male, because women develop more adipose tissues and less muscle mass than men. While age also contribute, and the like in the sense that the BMR is higher in infant and young children than adults, while weight also contribute in the sense that the greater the weight, the higher will be the BMR. Another important factors that also contribute is the body fat percentage. So the BMR is directly related to the lean body mass, in the sense that the person with well-developed muscles will have a higher BMR than the any obese person whose higher body weight is due to the adipose tissues. So basically all body tissues are metabolically active and constantly being broken down and repaired and participating in the different vital functions perform our body. So lower the body fat percentage, the higher will be the BMR. That's why men have higher basal metabolic rate as compared to women. Another factors which contribute is the diet, in the sense that during undernutrition, the basal metabolic rate may fall to at least 20 to 30% below normal, and that is actually recorded. While growth affect in the sense that growth hormones during period affect the basal metabolic rate. Thus, the basal metabolic rate increases during the first 5 years of life, rises again, and just before and during puberty, and decline into the older age. Climate, in the sense we can say that the person which is living in the tropical climate, its BMR is about 10% less than those in the temperate zone. So we can say that the cold exposure increases the basal metabolic rate. The body temperature or health also affect, in the sense we consider the fever, which increase the basal metabolic rate. For every 1 degree centigrade rise in the body temperature, the basal metabolic rate increases by about 7%. Gland and the hormones or glands also affect the basal metabolic rate, and the hypothyroidism decrease basal metabolic rate up to 30%, and hyperthyroidism may increase the basal metabolic rate up to 100%. And this totally depends about the severity of the conditions. And the physical activity, it's also have a very important effect on the determining the basal metabolic rate, in the sense that if an individual takes of any physical activity about half an hour before the basal metabolic rate determination, there is appreciable increase in the BMR observed. So next, the growth and illness also have an important contribution in determining the oral calorific requirement of a person, and in the growth and the recovery period, which may be during after the severe and the prolonged illness, both are associated with the positive energy balance, and though both condition needs an extra calories required by the body. The specific dynamic action also affect also contribute in determining the overall calorific requirement of a person, and it can be defined as it is basically the extra heat which is produced over and above the actual heat to be produced outside from a given amount of the food when the food given food is metabolized in the body. So a food has simultaneously effect on the basal metabolic rate, and the basal metabolic rate of a person increases by about 8% when food is ingested, while the heat produced here will be of no use to the body except for its role in the body temperature regulation in cold and warm. So overall, we can conclude that before stopping the closing the lecture, we can conclude the overall lecture that the basal metabolic rate reflects the amount of energy required to maintain body at rest, and it is the minimum energy needed to sustain involuntary actions like heart beat, respiration, iron transport, and maintenance of cellular integrity. Two methods are basically used to determine the basal metabolic rate, and the first is the direct calorimetry, and second one is the indirect calorimetry, and there are different factors which affect the basal metabolic rate and overall the energy expenditure. So there are different formula which are used to maintain the calorific level by taking into account that we should consider the age, gender, height, weight, lean body mass, and activity level. So here the different references are given, and you can having a look in these, you can get extra material by using then these references can be available online. And thank you very much for listening.
Pause recording. Stop recording.